So now what I showed you so far is not really an algorithm, but it has some elements in common with them. And algorithms are really cool, and that's what the focus of this class is about. One of the reasons algorithms are cool is that they're really useful. Without careful algorithm design, we just don't see fast enough responses from things like websites and user interfaces, stuff that we really depend on to be able to have the computers react quickly. Another is that they're really clever. They're really pretty mathematically. So just like a magic trick, sometimes learning how it does what it does can be just as exciting as what it actually accomplishes. So the practical part of algorithm design is trying to figure out how to make your programs fly. That is to say, go really, really fast. And there's a couple different ways that you can do this when you're programming. One is you should take a great deal of care in organizing your programs so that they're not doing a lot of wasteful stuff. So that goes without saying, but I said it anyway. There's a lot of time that you can spend tweaking loops and other things in your program to just get rid of little bits and pieces of inefficiency, and that's important. But perhaps the most important thing is good algorithm design. So whenever your program is doing something that involves a great deal of computation, you need to think hard about how to organize that computation so it does what you want it to do, but it does it fast. And that's the focus of this course. So we can think of the problem of developing algorithms for particular problems as a kind of algorithm itself. Here I've written it as kind of faux Python. You can't actually run this. I would not suggest running this, but it should give you sort of a sense of the flow here. So what we start off with is some kind of problem specification. And we'll talk about a couple different examples of those over the course of the course. For the problem specification we're currently concerned with, what we're going to do is we're going to start off devising an algorithm for that problem. So that means thinking about it, coming up with some kind of a strategy or plan for doing the computation, and we'll call that our algorithm. We're not really done yet. We need to make sure that this algorithm is actually correct. So the first thing that we want to do when we propose an algorithm is actually analyze the correctness with respect to the problem specification to see if it actually accomplishes what the problem says you're supposed to accomplish. And sometimes that is kind of obvious and straightforward, and sometimes that involves a fair amount of mathematical analysis. And we'll see different examples of those as we go. Once we've analyzed our algorithm to make sure that it's correct, we can analyze its efficiency. So it does what it's supposed to do, but does it do it fast enough? And we eventually determine the running time of the algorithm. If it's not correct, or if it's not fast enough, then we need to continue this process, re-devise an algorithm and reanalyze it, and keep doing this until we have something that both solves the problem and it solves it fast enough, and that's the algorithm that we declare to be our solution.